Happy afternoon. It's nice to see a lot of mixed audiences. Sometimes when I go to speak, there's a lot of ladies around, or sometimes it's only men, and I think this is a very good mix, I should say. Vaithi, I think, did the fantastic job of keeping all of you all awake. I was just thinking, because when he said 2:20, I thought maybe I'm going to speak immediately after lunch. I was so relieved when I saw him on stage, actually. I'm going to spend about, 15 minutes to share why I came back to do this, and then perhaps share with you some of my entrepreneurial journeys and lessons, okay? So an e-bike is a disruptive innovation. Have we disrupted gasoline? Not yet. Will the disruption happen? Yes. When will it happen? I don't know. But is there a market? Definitely yes. Because we wanted to do 1 million electric two-wheelers shipping out of Coimbatore in the next about 5 to 8 years. The reason why we are so sure and we are quite bullish about it is that we exactly did what Vaithi just said. We didn't innovate for the sake of innovating. We did not want to reverse engineer and say that we did a fantastic product. We just understood the market, worked on the market, and wanted to do something where people can commute at affordable cost. So what does an e-bike do today for us? It gives three things. It gives cost savings, because you commute, the capex is 25% cheaper than gasoline bikes. The opex is 1/10 of petrol. So it's a very compelling proposition. Second is that convenience. Just a 5-amp socket I can charge, and then I can ride a bike. I don't have to go wait in the petrol kiosk to fill in petrol. Number two. Number three, freedom, completely empowered. I don't have to ask my spouse or my child to go drop here, there, etc. So when I'm completely empowered, will I not be able to use my time productively to enhance my economic livelihood? And that is precisely what is happening in our venture. Let me give you a small story, okay? This is just a real life entrepreneurial story. I don't come and talk what is there in the book. In any of my talks, I only talk what I went through, because it's going to be relevant, and if I can do it, everybody can do it, right? So the market was actually going at 100-200% in 2008, and then suddenly came a very big roller coaster shock. The government abruptly discontinued a policy that they were continuing. Abruptly, okay? So for entrepreneurs like us, when a policy is changing off, what should you do? I mean, your fixed costs remain the same, isn't it? Everything remains the same. And you're doing 600, 700 vehicles per month, and thereby, you know, after the policy changes, it comes to 50 vehicles per month. So you have a huge challenge of not only managing your cash flows, but you have a huge challenge of keeping the team happy and making them retain and making them to work towards your goal. So I was in a factory one night, about 8 o'clock, because Deepavali was coming. I was just thinking in my mind, how do I manage to give Deepavali bonus and all that, right? And then there are about 5-10 people come. I mean, my factory workers come, about 20 of them. 5 ladies and 15 men come to say, I said that they are going to ask all this and I have to have an answer. As they came closer to me and they were asking about the company and all that, there was one lady who came, she's still working with us, came to me and looked at my eyes. Enna madam nammalku problem? Avlo arumiyana product. Neenga poi order kondu vaanga madam. 24 madam naanga vaichu ungalku deliver pandrom. Oh my god. That was a lightning. That was the purpose of my life achieved in that story. You don't have to meditate. There comes the enlightenment, right? Then I realized that this venture is not a commercial venture. We have to give shareholders value. But it was actually making a lasting, lasting social impact. Because the workers in my factory were all then retrenched textile mill workers. And here I am giving them a job, giving them a platform for them to feel occupied and for them to kind of contribute to their family, to their children, and thereby living a very, what do you call, dignified life. The moment I kind of understood that, no turning back. So that's the kind of a platform today we are in, and where we are kind of really understood our roots, we have understood our markets, we have understood our customers, and we are actually kind of quite scaling systematically, right? like Vaithi said about innovation, I mean, very superbly articulated. You can't innovate for the sake of innovating. You can't innovate every Wednesday, 2 to 5. It's just not possible, right? I will share a couple of videos later in the talk as to how we innovated for a spinning mill. We also will share how we innovated for a textile, I mean, for an industrial application here, okay? Because innovations has to happen when you have a need. Most of our innovations today are done with the customer in mind, okay? Because when we know that there's a customer there to kind of pilot and give you feedback, that's the best thing to have to be able to get a product successful very quickly. Vaithi was mentioning about faster, better, cheaper, okay? So when you apply this faster, better, cheaper, which is what I want to apply to our 1 million plan, it's a lot of work. It's not going to be easy. It's a stupendous work, which means if your team is not with you, 100% you are marching towards failure. If you even see towards the class by which Uber is scaling up, okay, and you see the other competitor in India, that's a way of a difference, world of a difference, right? So from our experience, we actually started to do getting into electric vehicles in a very large context. You know, there is significantly 4 key triggers actually that actually drove me to come back to, you know, make this venture successful. The first thought was, if a neighboring economy like China can consume 42 million electric vehicles, why not India? Where was the problem? Why is that people are so not at all, for this? Then we understood that when we went with research, we understood the problem wasn't battery and the charger. There was no problem with the technology. Electric came as early as 4 times, you know, almost in 1960s, right? Electric is not something new, right? So that was one. The second reason is that why can't we not do decentralized manufacturing? Because manufacturing is always central, 5 key big players and 5-6 players, gasoline bikes have been dominating for the last 30-40 years. I thought that should change. Because if a decentralized manufacturing has to happen, it is very clear that the key components has to be indigenized. What are the key components? You have a motor, you have a controller, you have a charger, you have a DC-DC converter, and of course the battery. Battery is not a commodity, you don't have to reinvent that. But you can actually do the other things. I always tell, you know, to my employees and my customers, electric vehicles are 5-6 technologies together. You have a motor, which is electrical engineering, right? You have electronics, I mean, controller charger, which is electronics engineering. You have the battery, which is chemical. You have metal body, metallurgy, internal. So multiple technologies in one product. You just cannot import components, assemble, and say that you've got a brand. No way possible, right? So the second one was decentralized manufacturing. The third one was we wanted to see that why not India can be a low-cost EVs export hub, right? There are a lot of laboring economies. You have the Nepal, Bhutan, and you have Sri Lanka, and all that are looking for even more affordable products. So why can't India be an export hub? Right? And so these were thoughts. The fourth one was, why can't we actually proliferate the market, particularly the tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 segments with electric cycles? Because in a village, if you look at it, all they are looking point-to-point commute. From Annur, he has to come to Coimbatore, right? From Sulur, they want to come to Coimbatore. What is the driving distance need? It's only 20 to 30 kilometers one way and going back another 20 kilometers. So up and down, the need is only 15 kilometers per day, right? We had a very interesting feedback from a postman in Annur. He came and told me, "Madam, unga vandi super ah irukku, madam." He was one of our very early customer. "Solunga sir, eppadi vandi ungalku useful ah irukku?" "Sir, na modalla madam, na motorcycle vechinda madam. Na mattum dhaan use panna mudiyum. Romba difficult. En wife use panna mattaanga, en ponnu use panna mattaanga. Rendu perukkum vandi oda theriyum. So I am using the product only for myself." He said that unga vandi vanda peruga moonu perum naanga unga scooter use panna aarambichitom. First, the second feedback what they said was, "Enakku or 1.5 acre bhoomi irukku. மாடுலாம் இருக்குது, உங்கள் வண்டி போனோன்னா மாடி மறல்றது கிடையாது, ஏன்னா சவுண்டே வர்றதில்லை." செகண்ட் இன்சைட். த தேர்ட் இன்சைட் வாஸ், ஹி செட் தட், "நான் ஒரு தடவை அன்னூர்லேருந்து கோயம்புத்தூர் வரப்போ எனக்கு ஒரு நாளைக்கு 70 ரூபா கண்டிப்பாக ஆகிடும் மேடம், போயிட்டு வந்து எல்லாம் பண்ணுறதுக்கு 1 லிட்டர் பெட்ரோல். உங்கள் இதில் எனக்கு மேக்ஸிமம் 10 ரூபா தாங்க மேடம் அது, வந்து போட்டு சார்ஜ் பண்ணி இன்னொரு சார்ஜ் பண்ணிவிடுவேன்." வாட் பியூட்டிஃபுல் இன்சைட்ஸ், ரைட்? ஸோ வென் யூ ஆக்சுவலி லிசன் டு யுவர் கஸ்டமர்ஸ் டீப்பர் அண்ட் டீப்பர், யுவர் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி கேன் பி ரிஃபைன்ட் பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி. Okay, so it is always that when you have a strategy, one time if it works, you just cannot stop it at it. You have to go higher, deeper, beyond of that strategy to make it work sustainably, thereby build $1 billion business, right? So it is going to be that level of challenge. The other aspect that I wanted to tell is that, so these were the, sorry, 4 triggers of why I wanted to start this and why I came back to Coimbatore saying that, because I'm not from Coimbatore. I just came because I studied, I was alumni of GCT, தட்ஸ் ஆல். ஐ ஹவ் நோ கனெக்ஷன்ஸ். மை ஃபாதர்ஸ் எ ப்ரொஃபஸர், மதர்ஸ் எ டீச்சர். ஒரு ஏக்கர் பூமி எனக்கு இல்லைங்க சார், அவ்வளோதான். ஓகே, சொந்த வீடு கூட கிடையாது.